एटीपी सिंथेस. द यूज ऑफ प्रोटॉन मोटिव फोर्स फॉर एटीपी सिंथेसिस इज कैटलाइज्ड बाय एटीपी सिंथेस. ओके, एटीपी सिंथेस इज कैटलाइजिंग द यूज ऑफ प्रोटॉन मोटिव फोर्स टू प्रोड्यूस एटीपी. Now this multi-protein ATP synthase, F0, F1 complex or complex 5, these all are the same thing and they catalyzes the ATP synthesis when proton flows back through inner membrane down the electrochemical proton gradient. Okay, this thing causes the ATP synthesis, the flow of proton down the electrochemical proton gradient through the inner membrane. Now this ATP synthase consists of two components, F0 component and F1 ATPase. Okay, these two things makes up your ATP synthase. Now this F0 component of ATP synthase is embedded in the inner mitochondrial membrane. Okay, at the inner mitochondrial membrane, you have F0 component. Now this F0 component have 1 A subunit, 2 B subunit and 9 to 12 C subunit. Okay, that is what is the composition of F0 component is. It is made up of 1 A subunit, then 2 B subunit and then 9 to 12 C subunit. Now this C subunit consist of two alpha helices that span the membrane. Okay, this C subunit have two alpha helices that span the membrane. Now out of these two alpha helices, the second helix consists of an aspartic acid residue that lies at the center of the membrane. Okay, C subunit has two alpha helices. Out of these two alpha helices, the second helix contains aspartic acid residue that lie at the center of the membrane. Now this F0 is a transmembrane complex that forms a regulated H+ channel. Okay, F0 is forming a regulated proton channel. It's CHANNEL. There is an antibiotic called oligomycin. Okay, this oligomycin completely blocks the ATP synthesis. And how it is able to do that? Well, oligomycin is able to block the flow of protons through F0 of ATP synthase. And by blocking the flow of protons through F0 of ATP synthase, this oligomycin is quite able to block the ATP synthesis. Now the subscript O in F0 represents the inhibition of F0 by antibiotic oligomycin. Okay, oligomycin is inhibiting FO. That is the reason why FO is there. Now this F1 ATPase is made up of 3 alpha subunits, 3 beta subunits, then gamma subunit, then delta subunit and then epsilon subunit. So these subunits combine to give you F1 ATPase. Now this F1 ATPase is tightly bound to F0 and it protrudes in the matrix. Now the beta subunits of the F1 ATPase are the sites for ATP synthesis. Okay, at this beta subunit, your ATP synthesis is going on. Now this gamma subunit is present at the center of F1 ATPase. Okay, F1 ATPase is having gamma subunit at its center. Now this gamma subunit extends F1 and it interacts with F0. Okay, there is interaction of F0 and gamma subunit of the F1 ATPase. Now this gamma epsilon C9 to 12 ring complex, okay, this thing is the rotor That is, it is a moving unit. And this AB2, alpha-3, beta-3, delta complex, this complex is a stator, that is a stationary unit. You have a moving unit, you have a stationary unit in the ATP synthesis. Well, the moving unit is this thing and the stationary unit is this thing, which is hard to pronounce. So that is how the ATP synthase looks like. Now this is your F0 component and this is F1 ATPase. Now proton passes through this disk C unit of the F0, and because of this movement of proton through this C subunit, there is a rotation of the gamma subunit which is attached to this C units. Okay, protons are passing from the intermembrane space to the matrix through this disk of C subunits, and that is causing the rotation of the gamma subunit. Now this gamma subunit fits inside this F1 ATPase, which is made up of 3 alpha subunit and 3 beta subunit. And this F1 ATPase, which is made up of 3 beta subunits and 3 alpha subunit, do not rotate. Okay, it is fixed to the membrane. Okay, so the movement of proton through this disk of C subunit causes the rotation of the gamma subunit, which is fit into this 3 beta and 3 alpha subunit of the F1 ATPase. Okay, so that is how the ATPase looks like. Now this ATP synthesizes ATP by harnessing the proton motive force. Okay, the proton motive force is harnessed by the ATP synthase, and that is how it is able to synthesize ATP. Now this ATP synthase can also function in reverse, and it can hydrolyze ATP. Okay, the function of ATP, the ATP synthase is to synthesize ATP, but its function can be reversed, and then this ATP synthase is able to hydrolyze ATP to pump protons across the inner mitochondrial membrane. Okay, that is also possible. Thus, we call ATP synthase as a reversible coupling device, and it interconverts the electrochemical proton gradient with the chemical bond energy and vice versa. Okay, it can use chemical bond energy to produce electrochemical proton gradient, or it can use, usually ATP synthase uses this electrochemical proton gradient to produce chemical bond energies. Now this F1 ATPase was first extracted from the mitochondrial inner membrane, and it was purified by Ephraim Racker. Okay, this scientist here purified and first extracted the F1 ATPase from the mitochondrial inner membrane. Now this F1 cannot synthesize ATP from ADP and PI because it catalyzes the hydrolysis of ATP. Okay, F1 catalyzes hydrolysis of ATP and it cannot synthesize ATP from ADP and PI. And that is the reason why this F1 was early known as F1 ATPase. Why? Because it was able to catalyze the hydrolysis of ATP. Now this complete F0-F1 complex catalyzes the hydrolysis ATP when it is isolated. Okay, this isolated complete F0-F1 complex catalyzes the hydrolysis ATP, but its biological function is to synthesize ATP from ADP and PI. And hence this F0-F1 complex is more appropriately called as ATP synthase. Okay, just to clear here, this F0-F1 complex, when it is isolated, okay, when it is out of the mitochondrial inner membrane, then it catalyzes the hydrolysis ATP. But when it is in the its original biological state, that is in the respiring mitochondria, at the inner membrane of a respiratory mitochondria, then this F0-F1 complex synthesizes ATP from ADP and PI, and that is the reason why this F0-F1 complex is referred to as ATP synthase. So consider this is your inner mitochondrial membrane, and on that you have this F0-F1 ATPs. Okay. Now you are isolating the F0M and F1 ATPase from it. So this in white color are the F0 component, and in this green color it is your F1 ATPase. Now this F0 of this F0F1 ATPase shows electron transport but no ATP synthesis. And this your F1 ATPase shows ATPase activity, that is, it does the hydrolysis of ATP, but and the thing is that this F1 ATPase don't show ATP synthesis as well as electron transport. Okay, so isolated F0 show electron transport but no ATP synthesis. Isolated F1 ATPase don't show either ATP synthesis and don't show electron transport as well, and it shows ATP's activity, that is the breakdown of ATP. So isolated F0 and isolated F1 cannot synthesize ATP. Okay, the F0-F1 ATPase, this complex present in the inner mitochondrial membrane, shows ATP synthesis. That is how it is. Now this F1 particles are required for ATP synthesis, but they are not required for electron transport. Okay, F1 particles play a role in ATP synthesis, but they are not required for electron transport. Now the submitochondrial vesicles from which the F1 is removed by mechanical agitation cannot synthesize ATP. Okay, if you are not having F1, then there is no ATP synthesis. Now this separated F1, okay, separated F1 from the membrane is able to catalyze the hydrolysis of ATP. And that is the reason why F1 is known as F1 ATPase. Okay, when you isolate the F1 from the membrane, okay, from the inner mitochondrial membrane, then that separated F1 is able to catalyze the breakdown of ATP, and that is the reason why F1 is known as F1 ATPase.